Okay, hi there. My name's Jason Kelly. I'm the technical support manager for Midas consoles in the UK, and I'm going to be taking you through some of the features of our Pro 2 console. First and foremost, it's about mixing good audio. We, as a brand, are renowned for making the best sounding mixing consoles out there, and the Pro 2 definitely continues that that legend and that legacy. So you've got a great sounding console, so that when you push the fader up, you get some audio out of the speakers, it sounds great off the bat without having to go in and start EQing things straight away. We've spent a lot of time and a lot of energy designing some features into the Pro 2 so that it's an incredibly easy console to use and to get around. And this is particularly important because it's such a small, compact control surface. Generally with digital consoles, the smaller the console gets, the smaller the control surface gets, the more difficult it becomes to operate. And lots of layers of menus and buttons and functions becomes quite difficult and very long-winded to get to. The Pro 2 is all about speed. It's all about getting to things as quickly as possible. So we've developed some very useful tools to help you do that. The basic navigation on the console uses a scrolling system. So you scroll through your inputs instead of having layers of faders. I have the ability to see up to 24 inputs at one time by using the extend function. So normally this would be 8 vcas and 16 channel faders. By using the extend function, I can see up to 24 channels at one time and scroll them all together. So this allows me to see more of my console at one time. The key thing with the Pro 2 is really the advanced navigation functions that we've developed specifically for this control surface. So I'll go through the main navigation functions. Fader flip is probably, or mix on faders, is probably one of the very few generic digital console features that you'll find on pretty much every board out there. Our console will do that. You go into flip mode and then use the select buttons for your output section to bring the faders, the contributions onto these faders. We've taken fader flip a step further by developing something we're calling collapsed flip. And collapsed flip is enabled from the preferences just by clicking here. And what this then does is when I flip a mix, it will only show me the channels that are switched on to that mix. So it's a little bit like a filter, a viewing filter. So now when I select my mixes, all I'm seeing is the channels that are switched on for that mix. If I want to add a channel to my mix, so let's say for instance that this matrix output is feeding my keyboard player for a monitor mix, I can press and hold the select button. This opens up all the channels on the console, and when I select those channels, it switches them on for that mix, and I can now push up those faders and I would get audio to my keyboard player. The effects button works in conjunction with the internal effects. So any output that is patched to an internal effect can be accessed by pressing the effects button and then selecting that output. This brings the output up on the screen and I can access the functions using these assignable controls. When I don't want to see this effect anymore, I can either deselect the mix or I deselect the effects section. This can also work in conjunction with the flip button, so I can have both of those functions working together. So I can now see the contributions of the channels to that effect. And if I change it to a reverb, we can see that work. I've now got control over the reverb as well from the assignable controls. So everything that relates to that mix, I can see straight away. We can also bring our graphic EQs onto faders by hitting the GEQ button. And now any mix that I select that has got a graphic EQ on it, the VCA faders will show me the graphic EQ. and I can scroll through the filters with the scroll buttons. This, again, can work in conjunction with fader flip, so I can see the graphic EQ for that mix, and also all of the channel contributions to the mix at the same time. So I'm accessing multiple things simultaneously from a very small control surface. One of the most important features that we've developed for this console is this function here, which we're calling MCAs, or mix control associations. And basically, an MCA is a VCA for monitor engineers. So VCAs in a standard format are not very useful for mixing monitors because they only affect post-fader mixes. An MCA allows you to basically mix via VCAs for pre- and post-fader channels. So if I enable my MCA mode, as soon as I select an output, the VCA buttons basically relate directly to the channel that I'm mixing. So if I select mix number 10 and my vocalist wants more keyboards but less drums, normally I would have to go to each individual input channel and turn each one of them up or down, which obviously takes a lot of time. Using the MCA functions, I can turn down my drums by putting down my drum MCAs and push up my keyboards using the keyboard MCA. So this basically will turn up all of the keyboards that are associated with this group all up at the same relative levels. And this is a completely new way to mix monitors. It allows much more control and much more speed of access. As soon as I select a different mix, my MCAs go back to zero and I start again from a clear palette. And this is really an amazing way and such a fast way to mix monitors, and also to mix monitors and front of house from the same console. So that was a very quick introduction to the advanced navigation functions on the Pro 2. It's very competitively priced, sounds amazing. You definitely want to give one a try. Thanks very much.